earth, my friends. And no eternal life. Absolutely. So my friends, the Bible says that God's word is powerful and it's cutting like a sword. And it can cut through to the heart of man. It cuts through to the heart of man. And it cuts away all the BS. God's word cuts away all the potential. God's word, when we hear it, it convicts us. When I heard the word of God, it convicted me. I didn't know God, but I heard the word of God being preached. And something in my heart went, my goodness me, this is truth. Because God's word is true, my friends. All the newspapers that we buy, they're just all full of man's opinion. But the Bible has been written from A to Z, the beginning to the end of man's history. And man's history, what is man's history? Man's history is shaking their fist at God. Man's history is denying that there is a God who loves us. And God loves us so much. And he sent his only begotten Son Jesus, that whosoever might believe in him would not perish but have eternal life, my friends. Each one of you had no eternal life. My friends, each one of you has got a guilty conscience, because you're human. You'll have a guilty conscience, and that guilty conscience can be soothed and can be taken away completely, my friends, because of the sacrifice of Jesus. That's right, my friends.
Amen.
Jesus loves you very much. Bless you, little one. Bless you, granddad. Did you know that God loves you very much? And he wants you to turn to him, and he wants you to know him.
Yes, sir.
And I pray that that little child grows up, and granddad grows up to know Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
And grandma, now we've got grandma coming up into life. Grandma, little one, God bless you in your lives. And may you turn to him and know him. May you come to know him as a real God who loves your family very much. Who holds the sun in place? Who holds the moon and the stars in place? Huh? All the professors on television would have us say that it's some random big bang. My friends, do not believe the lie of evolution. Do not believe the lie of these space agencies that are telling us that there's some endless universe that is just with meteors set to crash upon us. This earth is created wonderfully in 6 days by our God, a mighty sovereign God, who on the sixth day created Adam out of the dust. And then he also saw that Adam needed a helper, and he created Eve. Adam and Eve. That's right, my friends. Adam and Eve is how God intended for this earth to be, for us to be blessing one another in matrimony and childbearing, and filling the earth as God wants us to do, to fill the earth and procreate. And in return, he would bless us, and we turn to him and ask him every day for his sustenance and his grace and his forgiveness. And you can know that, my friends, but he's coming back soon, my friends. Our God is coming back soon. Faces, my friends, there's going to be so many people that will go, I never knew. But actually, my friends, if you're listening to this message today, you are without excuse, because you have heard the gospel. And God will say to you, when you stand before him, if you have not turned to him, he will say to you, what about Steve preaching in Brighton? He preached the gospel, and what did you do about it? And what would he say? You'll have to say, I didn't do anything. And then he will say, depart from me. That's right, my friends. He will say, depart from me. I never knew you. But God doesn't love me any more than he loves each one of you as you're walking by. But the difference is he wants you to turn to him, my friends. He wants you to turn to him.
Amen.
Yes, my friends. He's coming back soon. There you go, my friend. Words of peace. What's this?